Hello everyone and welcome back to the world of finance. You are watching Finance Concepts with Nikhil. My friends, for today's discussion, let us pick up a wonderful topic. We talk about American depository receipts, global depository receipts, and Indian depository receipts, what people call as ADR, GDR, and IDR. But first, conceptually, let us understand what are these depository receipts in the first instance. Depository receipts are used as means in the international capital market to raise funds via issue of equity. Now, in this one line, the whole meaning has been captured, but just by reading this line, no one can clearly understand what are depository receipts and how do these depository receipts function. So let us talk a bit slower and in details. Imagine that there is a company in India willing to raise funds overseas. That means the Indian company is not willing to issue equity within India. It is willing to issue equity, but it wants the subscribers or investors which are located in different country, that is in foreign country. So foreign country investors would be subscribing for equity shares of the Indian company. This is the objective. But this objective cannot happen directly by those investors subscribing for these shares in Indian capital market. It will not happen. This will be happening through the system of depository receipts. So how this will work, let us try to understand in detail. And please look at the screen and we first talk about American depository receipts. So we follow up the same situation that we have an Indian company which has an objective of overseas fundraising, and we find that there are some investors located in the United States of America who are willing to invest in this Indian company. Now, these investors in the USA cannot directly buy shares of this Indian company. As I have just mentioned, you will need involvement of some intermediary. So the first intermediary that gets involved between this Indian company and the investors located in the US is titled as Overseas Depository Bank located in the US. The term overseas used over here is from the viewpoint and in the context of this Indian company. Let us understand what role this depository bank is going to play. My friends, this bank is going to play a substantial role because this bank is going to issue ADRs. Now, how this will work? The Indian company will be issuing the shares to this depository bank located in the US, and this depository bank, when it receives these shares, on the backing of these shares, it will issue certificates or receipts or instruments known as depository receipts. That means it will convey that yes, we have the shares in our custody. You may trade with these depository receipts as good as these are shares of this company. So practically, physically in hand, the shares don't go in the hands of the investors. The shares will lie with the depository bank, and what goes in the hands of the investor is the depository receipt. Now, there is one more intermediary that is going to get involved, and that is titled as domestic custodian. This domestic custodian, the word domestic again is used from the viewpoint of Indian company. So that means that domestic custodian is going to be located in India. This domestic custodian is going to be the agent of this depository bank located in the US. That means the overseas depository bank as its agent would have appointed a domestic custodian in India. Now, what role this custodian is going to play? Let us observe that on screen. So you would find one thing, that there is another intermediary that is getting involved, that is domestic custodian. So what will happen? The Indian company will be depositing those shares with the custodian. So the reason why this entity is termed as custodian, because in its custody it is going to hold the shares issued by the Indian company. Now, this custodian is the agent of this overseas depository bank located in the US. So, the moment this custodian is getting the receipt of these shares, it will provide acknowledgement of these share deposits to its main head, that is the depository bank located in the US. Based on the backing of those shares lying with the custodian, the depository bank will issue ADRs or American depository receipts. That means now these ADRs as financial instruments will be purchased by these investors in the USA. So here we see that ADRs are ready to issue, lying in the hands of this depository bank. And on the other side, these investors in the USA, they have money in the form of dollars. You should not ignore this fact that the investment will be made in dollars. Now, these investors, they are going to subscribe for these ADRs by depositing the money in their hand with the depository bank. And obviously, in turn, the depository bank is going to issue ADRs to these investors in the USA. Now, these ADRs are basically marketable instruments. That means, once the ADRs have been issued by the depository bank and they are held by the investors in USA, among themselves, they can keep buying and selling these ADRs. One very important concept that you need to understand, my friends, that these ADRs are documents, are receipts, they are certificates where there is a backing of the shares issued by the Indian company. That means the shares issued by the Indian company are the underlying instruments to these ADRs. That means these ADRs have their underlying instrument as Indian company's shares. With the fluctuation of the price of share of the Indian company, the value of ADR will also fluctuate, because the ADR is going to derive its value from the price movement of the shares of Indian company. And therefore, these ADRs can directly be traded among the investors in the USA. Now, one thing that is further to be understood, that these monies are lying with the overseas depository bank. The objective is to pass on this money to the Indian company, right? So, this overseas depository bank, it will deduct certain charges for arranging this whole thing. And obviously, there'll be some issue expenses relating to ADR. So, all the issue related expenses will be deducted out of this dollar investment, and then the remaining balance will be transferred to the Indian company. And finally, we see that ADRs, which are certificates of deposits of those shares with the overseas bank, are with the investors, and the money of these investors have finally been in the hands of the Indian company, and therefore the objective of overseas fundraising is accomplished. Let us note down this entire procedure step by step. So we are talking about raising funds by an Indian company through ADR. First thing, deposit of securities of an Indian company with a custodian bank, that is agent of the depository in India, and the custodian bank makes acknowledgement of deposits to the depository in the US. Third thing, the depository in the US then issues ADRs to the investors in the US. And lastly, the US dollar receipts in the hands of the depository are passed on to the Indian company issuing shares. Let us now talk about the meaning and features of American depository receipts. So first of all, it is a certificate or a receipt that represents shares of a foreign company owned and issued by a US bank that is known as depository. These are obviously issued in accordance with the provisions stipulated by Securities and Exchange Commission of the USA. The foreign shares are held in custody overseas, but the certificates are traded on one of the three major US equity markets, that is the New York Stock Exchange or American Exchange or NASDAQ. ADRs are denominated in US dollar, and funds in the hands of the share issuing company are also in the US dollars. Now, let us talk about the features of ADRs. ADRs are US denominated and traded in the same way as the securities of US companies. the ADR holder is entitled to the same rights and advantages as owners of the shares in India. My friends, please do not forget that we are talking in the context of Indian company. Therefore, in the second point, what we say is the ADR holder is entitled to same rights and advantages as owner of the shares in India. Therefore, any kind of dividend, bonus issue, right issue happening with this Indian company will have its direct impact on the ADRs also. Third point, ADR represents ownership in shares of Indian company that is traded in US stock exchange. ADRs pay dividend in US dollar and can be traded like shares of US based companies. The value of ADR fluctuates based on the price movements of the underlying shares. Let us now take an example on ADR issue, continuing with the context of an Indian company. So RIL in India requires raising of US dollar 1 lakh through ADR, and current exchange rate is given to you as US dollar 1 equals to rupees 70. One share of RIL is currently priced at rupees 1400. So my friends, if you can compare these two information, so one share of RIL is worth rupees 1400 and one US dollar is worth rupees 70. So if you can link up these two information, you can say that the equivalent value of one share of RIL will be rupees 1400 divided by rupees 70 per dollar, which would give you dollars 20. Now assume that for each ADR, the number of shares underlying will be 5 shares. That means 5 shares underlie each ADR. Now what you will find is worth of one share is $20 and 5 such shares are underlying for each ADR. So obviously the worth of that ADR will be 5 times $20, that will be US dollar 100. And now because the company is willing to raise US dollar 1 lakh, each ADR will be having worth of $100, and for raising $1 lakh, number of ADRs to be issued will be obviously $1 lakh divided by $100, that is 1000 ADRs to be issued to accomplish the objective. Alright friends, let us now move on to the next connecting concept, that is Global Depository Receipts, GDR. I would say after understanding what is an ADR, understanding what is GDR is not going to take any time for you. GDR is same as ADR. In the first instance, understand that there are just minute differences which we will talk about. But yes, GDR is same as ADR. So let us take that same example, but with one difference. This time, suppose that Indian company willing to raise funds overseas is not targeting the investors in the United States of America. Say it is targeting the investors in European countries, or say it is targeting typically investors in London market. So what will happen? This time the depository bank as well as investors are located in London. So what will happen? The whole issue will take place not in US stock market but in London stock market. And this time the depository receipt will not be titled as ADR, it will be titled as GDR, Global Depository Receipts. GDRs can be denominated either in US dollar or even in euros. So let us understand typical differences between the two so that you can distinguish and prepare. If your examiner is asking you a question, write up differences between ADR and GDR, you should be able to write some stuff over there. Don't just write one line. Okay, so please pay attention on the screen, I'll show you the needful content. So we are talking about differences between ADR and GDR, but first the common point between the two. ADR and GDR, both they are commonly used by Indian companies to raise funds from the foreign capital market. The principal difference between ADR and GDR is in the market in which they are issued and the exchange in which they are listed. My friends, it's a point worth taking note of. That is, they are differentiated on the basis of the market in which they are issued and the exchange in which they are listed. Further, that ADR is traded on US stock exchanges whereas GDR is traded on European stock exchanges. Going ahead, pointing out some more differences. While ADR is issued by a US bank, GDR is issued by the International Depository Bank, representing foreign companies' stock trading globally. So another important feature is, while ADR is traded generally in US, the GDR is traded globally. Let us talk about that difference also. Through ADR issue, funds can be raised in the US stock market. Through GDR issue, funds can be raised in any country's stock market except United States of America. Alright friends, let us move ahead and talk about the next connecting concept, IDR, that is Indian Depository Receipt. Now this is completely a reversal scenario. This time it is not an Indian company which is having objective of overseas fundraising, but a foreign company, that is a company located in a foreign country, is willing to raise funds in India. That means an Indian depository bank is going to issue depository receipts which will be identified as IDR, and the custodian this time will be located in the issuing company's country. That means issuing company will be issuing the shares, and those shares will be lying with the custodian in the same country. That custodian will be the agent of the Indian depository bank, and when it provides acknowledgement to the depository bank, the depository bank will accordingly issue IDRs. IDRs will be denominated in Indian rupee and will be traded in Indian capital market as if just they are shares traded in Indian capital market. Now what will happen? I told you this is a reversal scenario. This time investors in India are investing their money in the equity of the foreign companies. So let us note down something about Indian depository receipts. An IDR is a way for a foreign company to raise money in India. In an IDR, foreign companies would issue shares to an Indian depository, which would in turn issue depository receipts, that is IDR, to the investors in India. The actual shares underlying the IDR would be held by an overseas custodian, which shall authorize the Indian depository to issue the IDR. The IDR are issued by a domestic depository in India and denominated in Indian rupees. Alright friends, I am sure that you would have understood everything about the depository receipts and typically what is ADR, GDR and IDR. There is always a lot more to learn, but in this video it is just this much. So friends, if you want more and more videos like this, please stay tuned to my channel, subscribe to my channel. And one more request, please like and share these videos. Don't keep it to yourself, just share them so that people who are seeking information about depository receipts can also be benefited. Thank you so much for attending this class.